Okay, everybody, and welcome back to Learn with Minecraft Education. Today we are looking at how to get started on Minecraft as a teacher. So let's assume that you've downloaded the software, all your students know how to log in. What do we do first? Well, I asked the entire Learn with Minecraft Education community over on our Facebook page, and I got lots of really great pieces of advice for some real teachers to get started with teaching with Minecraft. Now, the first thing we need to understand is that Minecraft is a very broad educational tool. It's not purely a way to teach coding with linear development from lesson 1 to lesson 100. It's designed in a way that educators are able to select from a wide range of topics and challenges to teach however they like. Also, teachers can create their own resources and challenges tailor-made for their students. So we're going to begin by making the assumption that you are a computing or ICT teacher, and we're going to move forward from there. The first thing we're going to look at today is the Minecraft Education official website. So we're going to click Class Resources, we're going to click Get Trained, and we're going to go down to Learn to Play over here. Now, one of the really good things that the website offers is you can go down and you can do the Teachers Academy, which walks you through from the very, very basics of walking around in Minecraft, planning a lesson, exporting worlds, getting your students logged on and so on, and they're super useful. So play through these and you'll pick up all of the skills you need. Now, the first kind of tutorials I would look at is go to View Library, click How to Play, and click Start here. And here we've got a nice set of introductory tutorials that will give you all the, and your students, all the basic skills they need moving around in Minecraft and doing some of the basic things that they need to do for the lessons, okay? All right, the next thing we're going to look at is the Make Code and Tinker tutorial. So if you start a new world in creative mode with Code Builder turned on, you press C, you can load up a menu to select Microsoft Make Code. And here you can see we've got a whole raft of tutorials that are designed in a way to really encourage the students to join in. So we've got cool things like lava towers and spleef games and sandstorms and so on. And you can walk through those tutorials and learn a lot about coding. And if we go back here, you go to Tinker. Tinker's a similar thing, it's drag and drop coding. But there's some more really cool tutorials here. We've got Path of Petals and another spleef game and TNT cannons. And we've also got some agent trials that are a little bit longer, and it's all about moving your agent around and coding like so. Now, next is the Hour of Code. So from the home screen here, we click Hour of Code. Now, these are great because they are hour-long lessons, of course, that teach coding, but there's a little bit of an extra twist on there. So it might be bringing two villages together or putting out brush fires and so on. And they've also got the lessons plans included in the coding solutions, which is nice. Now, next, coding fundamentals. So let's go to our library, lessons. Let's go to computer science and go to block-based coding. And here you can see we've got some really nice coding fundamental, slightly longer lessons that are a little bit more in depth, that go deeper into the coding that we can do. Now, the next big thing really is explore the library. Okay, so for each of these lessons, you'll find lesson plans, educator's guide, but it really is, at this point when you've learned the basic skills with your students, it really is a case of using your skills as a teacher and finding resources that are right for your class and at the right point to insert them into the curriculum. There's so many good resources on here. You just need to go through them, try them out, and find ones that you think are going to work really well, and at what point in the year and at what stage of their learning is the right time to use these. So definitely try them all out and work with your students working through them to try and hit certain skills. Okay, so the next big thing is get online. There's a massive community around Minecraft education who are there to help you, okay? So join a Facebook group, subscribe to some YouTube channels. There's loads of really good resources out there that will teach you all about coming up with new lessons and ideas and implementing those in the classroom, and they're all well worth a look. So do check those out. All right, so next we're going to look at creating your own lessons. Now, no one knows your students better than you. Okay, so after a while, when you're familiar with Minecraft education, make some lessons. It might be on game design. It might be doing an archery range or a parkour level, or you know, making a stopwatch or anything like that for games. But your students will enjoy going through that process with you and will respond better to things that you've made, and you'll be able to teach them better as well. Now, the next thing is assessment. In Minecraft education, we have the book and quill and the camera, so you can insert screenshots of your work You can put some notes underneath. Students can write how they found it, and they can export that as a PDF, and they can put it in a shared drive or email it to you or however you want to submit assessment. Next thing is Python. Okay, so once we've got a lot of the key skills with our block-based coding, it's time to move on to Python or JavaScript, and there's lots of really good tutorials. We've got Python 101, which is a linear series of 10 lessons that walk you through coding with Python. And we've got the Pirate Island as well. Also, go back and do the hours of code and the other fundamental tutorials using Python as well. Next, collaborate, host worlds. Get your students to join, do building challenges, and get them working together to solve problems. It's a big selling point for Minecraft education, and the students love joining each other's worlds and solving problems with each other. Right, so as you can see here, there's loads of stuff you can be working on going through. Now, the big thing that's important to know about Minecraft education is you need to do some work when you come in to find the resources, go around the website, go online, and plan out a curriculum for your students. It doesn't completely hold their hand when they're going through a lot of the lessons. You need to have done the work first. Okay, so you need to go into Minecraft education, look at the lessons, play through the lessons, make notes, and decide how you're going to implement those. Okay, now, if you enjoyed today's video, please do like and subscribe, and I'll be back later in the week with more videos for you on Minecraft education. Take care.